gotta do this now. Normally I don't do a preview video, not for every game. I try to, but this week I gotta do it now because, for those unaware, I live in Orlando. Next couple days are not gonna be fun. So there is a good chance that you will not see a recap video from me for the fact that I may not have power for most of the weekend. Hopefully, if I do lose power, it'll just be Friday, and I'll have it back by Saturday morning. Crossing my fingers on that one. There's a good chance I'm not going to be able to watch this game. Even if I could, you got to conserve your phone, number one, even if I can watch it on that. Two, I don't know if there's going to be even a place open close by where I can just walk in and watch something. I don't know. But remains to be seen. We'll see. But if you don't hear from me or see a video pop up right after the game, you know, I'm still dealing with post-Hurricane Matthew. So I know there's a handful of you out there that wish the worst for me. And to those people, I say thanks. I'm glad I'm in your thoughts. Anyway, on to the game itself. Well, we just learned that Charles Walker is not going to play. That sucks. So they're down another key defensive player along with Will Johnson. Oh, and Tay Evans had to retire from multiple concussions this week. So defensively, I have no hope of stopping Texas at all. They will score points. My hope is that Oklahoma, too, can score points more than Texas. Hence the shootout in the Red River Shootout. I have no idea what to expect in this game. For the past 3 years or so, every time I think I expect something to happen, seems to be the opposite. So I'm going into this game thinking Texas is going to play their best. They're going to play like they played against Notre Dame, and they will more than likely win just because that's the trend lately. And I'm hoping I'm completely wrong on that, because the last 3 years, it's just been complete and utter crazy. So Baker's going to play, obviously. So look, in all seriousness, Oklahoma should win this game? Should? They're a double-digit favorite? But it's hard to get your hopes up based on the past few years. This is what Texas fans must have felt like, you know, during, you know, 2010 through 12. When it was just a nightmare for them. Now it's our turn to go through it. The difference is they're not like... What makes it weirder is the fact that Texas is... They're not just winning or like 2014, keeping it close. It's not like they're dominating the Big 12. They've sucked. And I mean really sucked. Texas fans will tell you that. I know some. They say, we suck. I don't know how we beat OU. So I'm just going to, again, fingers crossed and hope OU wins. This game belongs in FS1, that's for sure, the way both these teams have played. And, you know, there's the big hoopla by myself and many others, you know, getting upset over the fact that this game is not on ABC or, you know, a major national television channel. FS1, no disrespect, but it's not the same marquee as any other rivalry would be. But this year, yeah, kind of belongs there. But I'll give the fine folks at Fox credit. They're going all out. They have like a big pregame show, and they're rolling out the red carpet, and they're making us feel like that game matters. Wish it did in the national scene, but it doesn't. This is all about, this game is strictly about this rivalry, about pride, about red being superior to orange. Burnt orange, specifically. That's the worst orange of them all. Hate it. So, you know, I've gone on and on about memories of this game, great moments, and things like that. So, you know, who could forget 2001, the Roy Williams Superman? I've been to my fair share of Texas games. Have a 2-2 record, if I'm not mistaken. Let's see, 04, 5, 6, 9, 10. Actually, no, a losing record. I'm 2-3. So, yeah, it's probably better off if I'm not there, although that hasn't helped past few years. OU Texas, what a game. What moments, memories, legendary players. I'm just hoping for a W on Saturday. I'm hoping to record the podcast tomorrow for those who listen. No guarantees, but hopefully the bad weather should not get here till early Friday morning. So I will hopefully have my end recorded, and then Joe will upload it since he's safe and sound in Oklahoma, where there are no hurricanes imminent to strike. Not so lucky here, which is, it's kind of weird. Like, hurricanes never really hit Orlando that much. He had Charlie, like, over a decade ago, but that was, like, a rare instance. Usually, they always kind of, like, seem to miss Florida or Central Florida in general. It's always, like, the Panhandle or Miami, but guess it's Orlando's turn. You know, we've dodged them long enough, and blame Mark Richt for this. You know, the hurricanes and Coral Gables are starting to come to prominence again, and all of a sudden now we're getting a real life hurricane hit the state of Florida. So here we are. I went on the radio this week, the real, like, not as a caller, but as a someone who works on a show, and said that OU's going to win 42-17. I must be smoking crack, because I don't think OU can hold anybody to 17 points that's not named Kansas or Iowa State. Maybe not even Iowa State, because they put 42 on Baylor. I can hope. I can pray. My confidence is not very high, because I don't know what OU team is going to show up this week, just as I'm sure many Texas fans have no idea what Texas team is going to show up. That being said, I hope you all have a, for all my Florida peeps out there, hope you stay safe, hunker down, and we'll make it through this all right. And hopefully, we'll all have power back on by Saturday, so we can watch games and ignore the fact that we have to, like, carry large branches and trees that are in our front yard or sticking through our roof and, you know, to, you know, clean up the mess. But give Saturday to football. Do that on Sunday. Unless you're an NFL fan, then you're kind of screwed. Then you gotta watch TV. That's what you gotta do. You're a football fan. I'm done, and I might turn it early tonight. I don't know. Watch some Luke Cage on Netflix and go to sleep. That's my plan. I'm insane right now. Y'all have a good one. Peace.